Good morning, everybody. I am Dr. Kanhu Charan Patro, Neuroradiation Oncologist. Today, I am going to tell about target delineation in meningioma after post-op cases in radiotherapy experts. So if you see a meningioma, it is an extraaxial tumor, highly enhancing or brilliantly enhancing mass lesion, usually dural based, and this is the meningioma, this is the dural dura, and this is the displaced brain tumor, and this is the mostly extraaxial tumor. So to guideline for the target delineation meningioma, there are one publication in 2021, Istro ECRO guideline for target delineation of skull based tumor. You can follow this article, or RTAG 0539, energy oncology group, that you can go through this article also. So where is the conflicts? Where are the conflicts? What should be the GTB proper? What should be the dural tail to be included in the tumor CTB? Edema, should I include? Again, part of the hyperostasis. These 3-4 parameters should be discussed for the target delineation. So if you see the dural tail, this is the tumor here, this is the dural tail, and this is the thickened dura. So initially the dural tail was thought to be result from direct invasion of the dura by the tumor. However, subsequent demonstrated to be predominantly reactive process due to vascular congestion edema. Having said that, the literature still divided into whole wide range of prevalence of tumor invasion of the dural tail has been reported 0 to 100%, with generally highly prevalence in WHO grade 2 meningiomas. This is further complicated by presence of tumor cells in apparently normal dura adjacent to the tumor. Whether or not the dural tail should be resected, or if so much surrounding dura should be included in the resection, of we continues to be debated. The first introduced by the dural tail is first introduced by 1918 by Williams et al. Thickening of the dura surrounding the meningioma. So this is the dural tail, you can remember here, you can see here. So according to the guideline, the GTB should not be modified with respect to the dural tail. However, nodular dural enhancement will be considered as a target and will be included within the GTB. The dural tail don't include dural tail, but if there is no thickened nodular enhancement, you should include in the GTV. Another conflict part is the hyperostasis. Tumor invasion into the bone did not show any significant correlation with WHO grade 2 or MEI-1 indexing level. To achieve better Simpson grade of tumor, excision one should remove much bone in contact with the tumor as possible in all cases. The absence of hyperostosis, this is hyperostosis, and here no hyperostosis, these are hyperostosis. The absence of hyperostosis does not mean that absence of tumor is imminent. GTB should include hyperostatic or directly invade the bone during radiotherapy planning, thus within the attendant CTV. Target reduction is possible near adjacent skull as a natural barrier, but not permissible for a hyperostatic or directly inverted bone. To appreciate the hyperostatic bone, you have to go through the bone window of the CT scan. Is edema a part of GTV or CTV a part of the meningioma? Remember, cerebral edema need not to be included within the GTV or CTV, even in grade 3 tumors. So meningioma growth may be ischemia, VEGF A secretion, angiogenic factor spillover, recruitment of pial vasculature that causes the tumor, disruption of blood-brain barrier, and increased vascular permeability causes peritumoral brain edema. Again, another way, intratumoral water content, compressor of tumor venous drainage, intratumoral tumoral congestion, angiogenic factor spill-up, angiogenic factor spillover, increased vessel permeability, recruitment of cerebral pial vasculature, all and disruption of blood barrier. This leads to peritumoral brain edema. Remember, don't include cerebral edema, brain edema into GTV or CTV in meningioma. So, RTO is 0539 table. If you see, they have divided into three groups. Group 3, low risk, intermediate risk, and high risk. In low risk, WHO grade 1, gross tumor resection or subtotal resection. Group 2 is that is intermediate risk, recurrent grade 1 GTR or STR, new WHO grade 2 GTR, any WHO grade 3 GTR or STR. Recurrent grade 1 GTR or STR, new WHO grade 2 GTR, gross total resection. Group 3 high risk, any WHO grade 3 either GTR or STR, recurrent grade 2 GTR STR, new grade 2 STR, subtotal resection grade 2 is known as a high risk. So this is three groups, and they have group 1 low risk observation, group 2 54 grain 30 fraction, group 3 is the 60 grain 30 fraction. So these are the low risk, intermediate risk, and high risk. So what should be the GTV according to the RTOG 0.539, WHO grade 2 or new grade subtotal resection or grade 3 of any resection extent, GTV nodular enhancing tissues and tumor bed if post op, do not include cerebral edema or dural tail, CTV 54, GTV plus 2 cm but reduce 1 cm around bones unless there is a hyperostosis, then use 2 cm and other natural abelis to spare it. CTV 60, GTV 1, GTV plus 1 cm, PTV 3 to 5 mm. So you can see here, this picture is taken from RTOG 0539. You can see the lemon green is the GTV, CTV is around 1 cm and PTV is 1.3 cm. So don't you should include the 1 cm around the CTV, GTV, and you can give 0.5 to 0.3 cm for the PTV. So here, this is the pre-op GTV, one case I am presenting here, pre-op GTV. So post-op GTV, so there is a small residual around enhancing part. Defining the residual GTV, this is the residual GTV. You can see here, pre-op GTV, post-op GTV, that is a post-op residual. Then CTV 54, 2 cm. CTV 60 is 1 cm margin. And so this is, remember, this is the residual GTV, this is the hyperostosis area, so this is, you have to include the bone in bone window, and this is CTV 54, 2 cm, and CTV 61 cm. And handling to the dural tail is a delineation of dural tail scalvus meningioma. Only thickened dural tail is included in blue color, thus thickened dural tail. In contrast, linearly enhanced dura, white arrows, like linearly, this white enhancing structures, the dura should not be included in the GTV. Only thickened and nodular part of the dura include. Include hyperostatic bone, bony hyperostosis is associated with skull base meningiomas. All areas hyperostatic bone, yellow arrows, these are the yellow, you have to see in the bone window, and a potentially bone tumor was included in the GTV. So it should be included in the red contour, and a CT bone window setting is mandatory for interpretation of reference of your figure. So two things you remember, hyperostosis should be included in GTV and give around 2 cm, and we should appreciate in the bone window. So how to trim from inner base of skull, plaques, ventricle, optic rastus, brain stentorium? Don't go by edge of the plaques or ventricle. You should, so you have, when we are going to the brain window, we should skull bone, you have to see in the bone window. So see the how the different, the green you see with brain window and bone, and how the much, how much area we are missing. Then trimming around the plaques, at least go beyond the 0.5 cm along the plaques, so you should not go edge of the plaques. Trimming along the ventricle, take around the 0.5 cm around the ventricle, and should be included in the so this is taken for the glioblastoma, but don't trim along the edge of the ventricle. but you should include 0.5 centimeter of the ventricle plaques, bone. If there is a bone, if there is no involvement, if there is a hyperostosis, yes, include all bone or at least 2 centimeter. There is a concept called N-plug meningiomas. N-plug meningiomas refer to a specific meningioma, microscopy appearance characterized by diffuse extensive dural involvement, usually the extracranial extension of the calvarium, orbit and soft tissue. These tumors are thought to be collar-like, seed-like growth in the durameter, different from the usual globular meningiomas, usually with extracranial extension in the calvarium, orbit and soft tissue. All dural thickening enhancements should be included in the GTV. So this is, you can see, this is N-plug meningioma. You can see here N-plug meningiomas enhancement pattern. So this is the clivus part, how it is N-plug meningiomas. These are the N-plug meningiomas. So if you want to delineate properly, you can take the advantage of a rotator plate that will differentiate between the, when there is a bone and skull base. So if extensive and homogeneous meningioma skull base influence the nasal cavity, distinguish between the vital meningioma, other tissue such as a postoperative scarring, reactive tissues. Contrast enhanced T1 MRI, T1 rotator plate after 30 minutes. So these are the things you can so there is a hyper reactive tissues, there is a post-operative packings and everything. When in there is a doubt, you can take the advantage of the rotator plate and to further target delineation. So whether it is helpful in the target delineation, you can go through this article. And there is a, if you see, this is a normal pituitary and you have to be very careful. You should not include the pituitary because it also takes by rotator plate. Rotator plate image fusion a small distant lesion at the dorsal orbital bone. Physiological tracer uptake of the pituitary gland. See, this is the physiological tracer uptake. So you can take when there is a doubt, when there is a problem, you are not able to identify, you can take the advantage of rotator plate and based on the rotator plate, the target delineation, how it happens. So again, these are large skull base meningiomas with orbital invasion, close correlation to cella torsica, and physiological tracer of pituitary gland. CTV, GTV contours, red GTV PET, red is the GTV. GTV PET. Yellow is the CTV. And CTV enlargement, GTV, PET. Most of the times when there is a mostly olfactory meningiomas, skull based meningiomas, when there is a differentiation, it's very difficult. You can differentiate from the normal bone or invasive bone. You should take the help of rotator plate if your this is if it is available in your locality. So additional in GTV to CTV, additional margin expansion from GTV to CTV is unnecessary for benign meningiomas like grade 1 meningiomas. However, small margin of few millimeters may be added to the encompass potential areas of microscopic tumor infiltration in case of repetitive within tumors. Intracavernous portion of the proximal region of dural tail avoiding extensive coverage of the distal portion. For grade 2 grade 3 meningiomas, the CTV is defined as the GTV plus 1 to 2 cm of margin and might include the preoperative tumor bed, peritumal, but edema should not be included. Hyperostotic bone changes and dural enhancement thickenings are seen at diagnosis should be included. Margins may be smaller around the natural barriers to tumor growth such as skull into surrounding parenchyma unless there is evidence of an invasion. So, the last few lines. The GTV will be defined as the tumor bed on the postoperative enhanced MRI to include any residual nodular enhancement. Neither cerebral edema nor the dural tail to be specifically included in the GTV. However, nodular dural enhancement will be considered as the target, will be included in the GTV. For grade 3, grade 2 meningioma, CTV 54, plus GTV plus 1 cm, for CTV 60, grade 3 meningiomas, GTV 54 is GTV plus 1 cm and CTV 54 is GTV plus 2 cm. The CTV margin may be reduced 0.5 cm around the natural barriers to tumor growth such as the skull. Target reduction will not be permitted with hyperostotic or directly invaded bone. In which settings the involved bone must be fully included within the GTB. PTB 54-60 additional margins of 0.3 to 0.5 cm. And you can reducing PTB margins to modify organ settings is not generally permissible in PTB in nearly the vital structures. So this is all about the target delineation of the meningioma. You can, if you want, you can download my video or slides in slide set. And this is for your thank you for your kind watching. And you can subscribe my channel in YouTube to see the all my videos. Thank you very much.